Good afternoon. George Demos, a candidate for United States Congress in the 1st District of New York on Eastern Long Island in Suffolk County. 4 weeks ago, our campaign put out the first national call to rebuild St. Nicholas Church, the only house of worship actually destroyed on 9/11. Since then, the response from across this nation has been overwhelming. From coast to coast, people have stood up and said that it's time to rebuild the only house of worship destroyed on September 11th. On September 11th, right over there, St. Nicholas Church was destroyed by the South Tower when 3,000 Americans were killed by Islamic extremists, including 168 from Suffolk County, where I'm running. This church must rise again. It is our obligation to ensure it rises and rises from the ashes. It's absolutely critical that we do this. The problem is that the Port Authority has not honored its agreements. For over a year, the Port Authority has refused to meet with church officials. It has refused to go forward with a plan to rebuild the church right here at 100 Liberty Street, and that's wrong. The church has been, the site has been excavated without the approval of the church, and the Port Authority insisted that the church turn over its deed to the property before actually having a solid contract for rebuilding. So the time has come for the Port Authority to do the right thing, to stand up and to rebuild that church. 2 weeks ago, our campaign called on Governor Patterson, who expressed a tremendous concern for the mosque and asked for the mosque to be rebuilt in a different location. We called on Governor Patterson to exercise the same leadership and the same concern for the church and to rebuild the church. About a week ago, our campaign issued an open letter to President Obama, and we called on President Obama, in light of his remarks supporting the mosque, to rebuild the church, the only house of worship destroyed. Now, I disagree with President Obama's assertion. I happen to believe that the mosque being built in this location is inappropriate, provocative, and wrong. But certainly we can all agree that the St. Nicholas Church, the only house of worship destroyed on 9/11, must be rebuilt. We must do that, and we must do that now. Islamic extremists cannot, must not, and will not have the final word on whether this church rises from the ashes. I'm privileged to stand here today with former Governor Pataki and His Grace Bishop Andonios, the Chancellor of the Archdiocese, the Greek Orthodox Archdiocese of the United States. Your Grace.
Thank you, George. On behalf of His Eminence Archbishop Demetrius, who is out of the country accompanying our Ecumenical Patriarch in a pastoral visit, it's my distinct honor to be here today to officially thank George Demos and most especially Governor Pataki for his initiative to bring to the focus of the public's attention the rebuilding of our Church of St. Nicholas. This expresses not the concern simply of our own community, but of people across our great nation and the world to see this little church rebuilt, a church that was established in 1916 by Greek immigrants to this country and which had become a haven for people of all faiths who would often stop by, light a candle, and offer a prayer regardless of their ethnic, religious backgrounds. Very often politicians make promises, and with the passage of time they get forgotten. And we are encouraged that Governor Pataki, who early on, soon after 9/11, committed to the rebuilding of St. Nicholas, is here today to address that issue, and hopefully through the efforts of himself and other individuals, the day will soon dawn when St. Nicholas will indeed be rebuilt. A house of worship not simply for the Greek Orthodox community, but an appropriate monument to the 3,000 souls of all faiths who lost their lives that day, and a center of healing and reconciliation for all people. And so I thank Governor Pataki, former Governor Pataki, and hopefully his efforts and the efforts of everyone will bring the Port Authority back to the discussion table so that we can resolve this issue and rebuild our church.
9 years ago, when the smoke was still rising and the land was still hot and the ashes were still in the air, Governor Pataki walked amongst the smoldering ruins, and he made a solemn pledge and an obligation that this church would rise again. And I'm very pleased that Governor Pataki is renewing his call to ensure that this church rises again. Ladies and gentlemen, the 53rd governor of the state of New York, Governor George Pataki.
Thank you, George. And Your Grace, it's an honor to be with you this afternoon, and thank you for your spiritual leadership and your efforts to make sure that St. Nicholas is rebuilt here at the World Trade Center site. And to George Demos, thank you for your leadership on this issue, where you've been outspoken and an early advocate for the reconstruction. Father Alex, it's always great to be with you. And I just want to mention two others, Senator Dean Skelos, who wanted to be with us but couldn't be, and Nicole Maliotakis, who was my liaison to the Greek community on September 11th and worked to make sure that St. Nicholas was incorporated as part of the master site plan. We stand here at Ground Zero, and you can hear the sound of construction. The master site plan, which was brilliantly designed and is now being brilliantly implemented, is being constructed before our very eyes. Behind me, you can see the Freedom Tower rising. You can see the plaza where the voids will be for the memorial being constructed. You can see the Memorial Museum underground taking shape. And you can see the Calatrava Transport Hub being constructed in accordance with that master site plan. But there's one facility that has been left out of this equation that we promised on September 11th and in the days and weeks thereafter would be reconstructed, and that was incorporated as part of the master site plan for the rebuilding of the World Trade Center site, and that is St. Nicholas Greek Orthodox Church. Now, almost 9 years later, as the others take shape, there not only has been no progress made in the reconstruction and rebuilding of St. Nicholas, there is not even an ongoing discussion with the Port Authority officials. And by the way, after September 11th, it wasn't just I who said we are going to see that St. Nicholas is rebuilt. It was the leadership and the officials of the Port Authority as well. So I'm here this afternoon with leaders of the Greek community, with people who care, with people who understand the importance of being true to that master site plan, and I'm calling on the leadership of the Port Authority to reach out and engage in a dialogue with the leaders of the Greek Orthodox Church so that we can resolve the remaining issues, have strong negotiations, and get St. Nicholas rebuilt here at the World Trade Center site. It is not just part of keeping a pledge made in September 11th. It's part of an understanding that the only house of worship destroyed on that horrible day not only should but must be reconstructed and must rise from the ashes, not somewhere else, but right here at Ground Zero. So again, to the leadership of the Port Authority, it is past time. Reach out to the church officials. Sit down. Have negotiations. Resolve the issues so that St. Nicholas can be rebuilt as quickly as practically here at the World Trade Center site. Thank you very much for being here.